Good evening and welcome to the 74th edition of the Wildcat Sports Network. I'm Connor Jenkins, taking over behind the desk for the 2021-2022 athletic season. On tonight's show, we talk Wildcat football as the Wildcats prepare for a monumental game against powerhouse McKinney, Texas. We will catch up with Coach Wood and discuss the big changes in both staff and players this year. Plus, volleyball season is about to get underway, and we will sit down with Coach Lloyd to talk Wildcat volleyball, as they are looking to get that state title with a massive returning roster. It's Saturday, August 28th, 2021. Friday Night Lights are back, and the Wildcat Sports Network starts right now. Joining us in the studio to kick off the 2021 football season is head coach Chris Wood. Coach, we've had a lot of new additions to the coaching staff. Chris Gagg as your wide receiver coach. You've got Kalen Cleveland as your new fullback coach. At the same time, you're switching up some coaches around. What can we expect from the changes this year?
Well, I mean, we've kind of turned the staff over a little bit. And, it starts with Benji Mahan, our new offensive coordinator. We hired him in early summer. He was able to take part in spring ball, been with us all summer. Previously, he'd been at Fayetteville, been the offensive coordinator there on some really championship-level teams. And so he's brought in a tempo and an energy, and he's done a really fantastic job with our offensive staff and our players, getting the system installed. And then we've added Coach Greg at our receivers coach. You know, fortunate really to have him on board. He's coming. Played for in the NFL for 5 years, a former Razorback, and then worked at Memphis last year on the coaching staff. And so to be able to add him as a receiver coach, I think has been huge for us. Really good energy guy, really knows the position, can teach our kids. Kellen Cleveland's come on to help us with our fullbacks, a guy that played here his last year really in college before he goes into the workforce, wants to be an educator. And that's some really good experience. So to add him with a Bartley Webb that's taken over offensive line for Justin Pruitt that's went to Broken Arrow and new OC there. And Bartley's doing a good job for us. And then Gary Ware and Tyler Dorton, of course, are back coaching running backs and quarterbacks respectively. On the defense side of the ball, Coach Moreland's back to run our defense. Brandon Haney shifted down to our defensive lines, doing really good work there. Chris Thompson's moved from the secondary to inside linebackers. Jacob Robertson, a former player, is now the outside linebackers coach. Jordan Stokes is coaching corners for us as well. So really like those 11 coaches. They really, they do a good job. They want to serve the program. They want to put our guys in a situation to be successful. I like what they've done so far and ready to see them in action this Saturday.
I mean, yeah, along with those coaches, there have been a ton of new additions with the players as well. Also the switching up of some positions. Mm-hmm. You got Luke Buchanan, the new quarterback. You've got Braxton Scott and Drew McClendon switching to receiver. I mean, what's the reason for these changes and these new additions?
Well, the biggest thing is you go into the year and you really don't want your guy stuck behind another one and just being a backup where they can help us be successful. You know, so once we got going through our summer and with some guys that had moved in and then just other guys coming back, you know, they want to help us win football games. And if they can move to a position to do that, we want to put them in the situation best to help us be successful and give them an opportunity on the football field. So Braxton Scott, you know, has played quarterback his last couple of years. But when he was in junior high, he'd play some corner. So he's moved over playing corner for us, doing a really good job over there. Lane Reeder, which was splitting reps a little bit with Hudson Brewer, dynamic athlete. And so why have him as a backup and minimizing his opportunities when you can enhance those and get him on the field? And he's moved over to corner as well. Really does a good job in man-to-man coverage. He's athletic and explosive, so we can use him in special teams. And so both of those corners, you know, are going to be new to the position, but they're seniors, so they understand the standard of what we're trying to accomplish. I like what they're doing. It allows us to move Malachi Kramer to safety, which he started all year at corner, but he's done a heck of a job at safety for us through the summer. offensively looking at us. Drew McClendon, we slid him out to receiver. We had that flexibility when Luke Buchanan came in and really did a good job through spring and summer trying to solidify that quarterback position. So Drew McClendon, explosive. I mean, just like in the benefit game last week, first time he touches the ball, he goes 56. And so we're just trying to use his skill set to the best of his ability to put him in a situation to be successful and also our team. And then we got, of course, Luke Buchanan. And then outside of that, most of the rest of the guys are back. Peyton McKee, you know, moves himself to an outside receiver on the left side. And Ethan Fender's back at a slot receiver. So, you know, when you get into the deal, you just try to put those puzzle pieces in the best situation so they can only not only have success, but it helps our football team win games.
I mean, following that, what's kind of been the focus during this preseason?
Well, I mean, the biggest deal is just trying to break in our offensive line. You know, we've got four new guys up in the offensive line. We have, sorry about that. We have, you know, Jack Struben's back for his fourth year, and he's the anchor of the offensive line. But we have four juniors that are going to be in there doing some things. And so they need experience. The same thing with our defensive line. And just, I think on offense, we'll probably start, I think, around seven juniors. And so just trying to get them up to speed. Same thing on the defense. And physicality is big. So that's kind of what we focused on.
Coach, thanks for joining us. We'll bring Coach Wood back on later to help us close this thing out. But player-turned-reporter Cameron Bolin took to the sidelines to go behind the scenes on this year's changes and just what to expect in the upcoming season. Take a look.
As the football season opens up tonight in McKinney, Texas, the HAR-BER Wildcat football team has a new look as both players and coaches take on a new role. Go!
Go! It's kind of always my niche, and then the offensive line job opened, and Coach Wood and I had a few conversations, and it ended up working out to where he felt confident enough to put me in the position.
Last year at running back, did all I could, but there was missing pieces on defense this year, so I was the guy to replace those pieces and just looking to help the defense again.
With the additional movement of six coaches and several players within the program, HAR-BER hopes to bring new eyes and experience to each position as they approach the season.
I haven't learned any like specific skills, but Coach Dorton, my quarterback coach, has helped me a lot with like my mechanics and my footwork and stuff.
After multiple position changes, HAR-BER has high expectations, building on several successful team camps trying to improve on last year's 5-7 season.
Set expectations high, but go to Little Rock and win the state championship. I mean, that's all we can do, but be the best. I mean, try to keep completions low, turnovers high, just try to get the offense back on the field.
I expect us to be really good. We have a lot of weapons at every position, and I think we'll do really good this year.
Every team makes its adjustments in the offseason, but this 2021 HAR-BER football team takes on a whole new look, trying to improve on last season and make another run at the state title.
Wildcats finished fifth in the conference last season with a record of 4-3, 5-7 overall. This year, the team looks to be firing on all cylinders, which they need, and they head into McKinney, Texas tonight to face the number 27 team in all the state. Watch the game live from McKinney, Texas. The game will be broadcasted for $6. In the meantime, let's take a quick commercial break, but when we come back, we'll have Drew McClendon in the studio. Don't go anywhere. WCSN, we'll be right back.
Presented by McLarty Daniel.
Come see the largest pre-owned inventory in Northwest Arkansas.
Whatever you're looking for, you'll find it in McLarty Daniel Country. With 800 pre-owned vehicles at six giant locations in Bentonville and Springdale, there's something for everyone. Plus,
at McLarty Daniel, you're protected.
Drive worry-free for 7 years or 200,000 miles with the MD Pre-Owned Advantage. And when it's time to sell your car, we're ready to buy it, even if you don't buy from us. Have you visited McLarty Daniel Country yet?
Visit us online at McLartyDaniel.com.
Ballpark Franks got their start in 1957, right here in the ballpark. And with the taste of 100% Angus beef, passed down from one generation to the next, they soon became a tradition everywhere, bringing on the feeling of summer in every bite. Ballpark Franks, Bring on summer. Ozarks Go from Ozarks Electric Cooperative is leading the fiber revolution. Connecting the divide with high-speed broadband access to close that gap. From cloud to cloud, post to post, from downtown to way out of town, to connect our customers to a world of blazing speed and access to absolutely everywhere. It's our customers connected.
At Northwest Health, we've made it easier to schedule a doctor's appointment. Online scheduling for our primary care physicians lets you make an appointment at any time, from anywhere. It's the new way to book your next visit. MyNorthwestAnyCare.com.
On the counter, find a hole, Garrett inside the five, touchdown Springdale.
Touchdown, HAR-BER Wildcats!
When I walk through the halls of my high school, I see the constant pressure to be a doctor, or go into business, or pursue athletics. What if there was an opportunity to be something more? Skills USA offers you an opportunity to explore careers that matter, careers that we need now. Hands-on trade skills, like electrical engineering, construction manufacturing, architectural drafting, and even television productions. With Skills USA, you can gain these essential skills that allow you to bridge the gap from education to careers right out of high school. Skills USA, champions at work.
Welcome back. Joining us now in the studio is new wide receiver, Drew McClendon. That's right, you heard it correctly. Quarterback to now wide receiver. Drew, thanks for joining us. Now, last season, you were the starting quarterback for the Wildcats. Now you've been moved to receiver. What kind of motivated that switch for you?
For me personally, it was more of a, I kind of wanted to change something, like switch something up like that. And then for the coaches, they also felt like we had a new transfer coming in. I was like, oh, this is probably a good time for me to come in. He's really good and stuff. So we talked to coaches and they were like, yeah, we want our best players out there and stuff like that. Biggest assets to us, and that'll help us.
I mean, the Wildcats finished last season in the second round, knocked out by Bryant, 48-22. How do you, like, just use that to fuel you and move past it?
I feel like it helps us a lot because we know it's our senior year and stuff like that. And we just see what how the seniors fell after that loss and just kind of motivate us not to end up like that.
I mean, of course, you had a long off season. You had a lot of time to reflect and reset. I mean, what has been the major focus heading into this next season?
For us, it's been changing up our offense a little bit. We have a lot of new plays and stuff like that, new skill people, especially me. And we have a new line, so we kind of have like a hurry up and try to beat them with conditioning and stuff like that.
Earlier, we talked about all these switching of positions and new additions in the coaching staff and in the players. Can you just give us like a player's perspective on all the additions and switching?
Personally, I think it's good. We have some new coaches in there, different concepts. Like Coach Mayhem, he's came in, offensive coordinator. He's switched things up and stuff like that. And Coach Gregg, a lot of experience playing football and stuff like that, the receiver position especially. And I think it's just good for us, like a little change.
Drew, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Good luck tonight. Let's take another quick commercial break to hear from a few of our sponsors. But don't go anywhere. Coming up next, we are changing gear and hitting the court to catch up to our Wildcat volleyball team. Don't change the channel. You're watching the Wildcat Sports Network.
Presented by McLarty Daniel.
If you want fast, easy, and affordable service, visit McLarty Daniel.
Keep your vehicle running like new in our state-of-the-art service facilities. We know your time is valuable. Our factory-certified technicians with decades of experience will get you in and out and back on the road quickly. We service all makes and models at our six convenient locations in Bentonville and Springdale, open 6 days a week.
Visit McLartyDaniel.com to schedule your service appointment today.
Hometown. That word still means something here. It means we're neighbors. We do the right thing. We care about your family. And you deserve the very best every time you walk in the front door. Harps. Hometown Fresh.
The Springdale Chamber of Commerce is among the top 1% of chambers in the nation to be honored with a 5-star rating by the U.S. Chamber of Commerce. We work each day to make our members more profitable through programming and events that strengthen our economy, help to create jobs for a growing population, and support the needs of a diverse community. We make Springdale a better place to live. Learn more about the Chamber and Springdale by visiting our website, springdale.com.
When you bank with First Security, you're choosing real support for you and for our home state. So friends, families, and fellow Arkansans find better solutions together. It's another way First Security helps Arkansas bank better. And it's why you should call on us today. First Security, bank better.
Experience everything Springdale has to offer. Visit ExploreSpringdale.com or download the new Explore Springdale app. It's the best place to discover all there is to do and see in Springdale. We'll help you explore our many eateries and attractions and introduce you to our shopping, arts, parks, and trails. You'll also find links to our great hotels and meeting venues. Download the new Explore Springdale app or visit ExploreSpringdale.com to begin your Springdale adventure.
So, Shane Matthews, his lightning fast speed.
No. He's got explosive speed.
Dude, he's lightning fast.
Shane, would you describe your speed as explosive or lightning fast?
What?
Dude, I'm telling you, he's explosive.
Dude. Lightning fast.
What's that? Lightning fast.
Lightning fast.
Yeah. Welcome back. Joining us now in the studio is 3-year head coach, Cassie Lloyd. Coach, can you talk briefly about your expectations for this year? You only have one non-senior on this team, so what's your expectations?
Yes, we're very senior heavy, and that's been a lot of the conversation among everybody that's been talking about HAR-BER volleyball, but I see it as a total blessing. This group of 14 seniors and then Galatia, our sole junior on our roster, they're experienced, they're competitive, they've been with each other since junior high and elementary school, so they know how to handle each other very well. And just that, the relationships that they've built on the court and off the court, I think will help us be really successful this season.
I mean, arguably one of the biggest rivalries in this sport for you guys, even more so than HAR-BER versus Springdale, is HAR-BER versus Fayetteville. I mean, last year you lost in the semifinals to the Purple Dogs. How do you use that to fuel your team during this offseason and come back stronger?
Yeah, we talk about last season and our semifinal match a lot, and we tell the girls the reason we talk about it is because we want to learn and grow from it. Obviously, Fayetteville won state last year, and they, too, returned majority of their starting lineup. So it's going to be a gritty battle. They're a very high-level volleyball team, but so are we. And so we just kind of try to focus on HAR-BER volleyball and what our goals are and maintain a strong mindset when we match up against high competitive teams like Fayetteville.
What's been the focus during the offseason and even as we head into the conference in just a few weeks?
Offseason, we've really focused on getting stronger in the weight room and pushing our mental game. We have the volleyball skill. All of our returners are very seasoned. They're very high-level volleyball players, but we talked about what's going to be our setback is going to be our mindset and our mental toughness. And so that's been something that we've been really focusing on this preseason, and hopefully rolling into conference will be mentally strong.
3 years ago today, you took on the position of head volleyball coach, moving up from assistant, and now you are the head coach of one of the strongest teams to ever come through HAR-BER. How do you think this group has influenced you as a coach and vice versa?
This group is not just amazing volleyball players, they're amazing people. And we talk about it all the time as a coaching staff, how blessed we are to have these 14. Because you would think with that large of a senior class, there'd be a lot of drama, a lot of complaining about playing time. But everyone in this class just really molds into their roles and makes our job really easy. They're a group that works hard every day when they come in the gym. So from the coaching aspect, they make our job a lot easier, and it's really, really fun. But they impact me to be a better person, not just a better coach.
Finally, Coach, what would you like to say to everybody that's going to come watch the games and come support the Wildcats?
Just that this senior class is ready to hopefully make history in HAR-BER volleyball, and they're amazing kids. They put in the work, and we would love for them to cheer us on.
Coach, thanks for joining us, and good luck on this season.
Thank you.
This season, our Lady Wildcats have set their minds on a state title and has nearly all players are returning from last year. This team looks to be the biggest threat in the state. Reporter Chloe Hester went courtside this week to bring you the inside story. Take a look.
With volleyball season approaching and a senior-heavy team, the state title finally looks within grasp.
I think that Coach Lloyd is really, she knows, what we're capable of, and she's done, a great job of pushing us every day. if something's off, like, we're going to talk about it and we're going to fix it. We're not going to, like, let it go just because she knows we're good. Like, we're going to fix the small things.
Coming off of a tough loss at the semi-stage last year, Coach Lloyd and her senior leaders have been working hard for a chance of redemption.
So we've talked to the seniors a lot about just leadership and how they need to hold their teammates accountable. We have 30 kids on our team. 14 of them are seniors, so almost nearly half our team is seniors. So they have such an impact not only on this season, but the legacy that they're going to leave with HAR-BER Volleyball. And so they really want to reach goals that HAR-BER Volleyball has never done before.
After a lot of hard work and dedication, our Wildcats are prepared to prove what they're capable of this coming season.
I think playing for each other, but also losing state last year in the semis, I think really fuels us to really work hard for one another and to get a state championship for HAR-BER. Everyone is really good leaders, and they all have great hearts and great characters. And the volleyball skill is there, but even the personalities is just amazing, and I love being on the team.
As our Cats are preparing for season to start, they are more ready than ever to prove themselves in the 6A West.
With volleyball season approaching fast, the Lady Wildcats are ready for conference play, which starts September 2nd. WCSN will be there for all live event coverage. Find us on the Springdale Public Schools YouTube channel. We're going to take a quick commercial break to hear from a few sponsors who make this show possible. But stay tuned. Up next is San Diego State commit, Kat Cooper, as we catch up with her on the goals this year. Plus, much-anticipated volleyball hype video. Don't go anywhere. WCSN will be right back.
Hey, Northwest Arkansas. Lara here at Sam's Furniture. If you're looking for new furniture, we have over 170,000 square feet selection at everyday low prices and same-day delivery available. But the best part is that we love to serve our community. So when you buy at Sam's, part of your purchase goes to support one of the many amazing organizations that we have been blessed to partner with. Serving others, especially those in need, is our culture here, and we hope that you'll be a part of that too. Arkansas's largest furniture destination. Get it at Sam's.
Nothing says game day like good friends and great food. And at Slim Chickens, we know great food. From our 100% all-natural chicken tenders, fresh-made wings served with house sauces, to delicious chicken sandwiches, crisp salads, southern sides, and desserts you just can't get anywhere else. At Slim's, we have the food you love, made fresh for the people you care about. Dine in, drive through, or order online. Slim Chickens. Fresh, delicious chicken.
You can love where you live and play at an apartment community managed by Lindsay Management Company. Affordable apartments with awesome amenities, including clubhouses, fitness center, pools, tennis and basketball courts, and playgrounds at select locations. Many locations also include golf privileges, business centers, game rooms, tanning beds, whirlpools, saunas, and resort-style swimming pools. View rates, photos, and apply online at lindsaymanagement.com.
When you choose First Security, banking is just the beginning. Here, we take care of each other, making the community we all share even stronger. So people in Arkansas can build a life, buy a home, run a business, and more. Strength in numbers and neighbors. It's another way First Security helps Arkansas bank better. And it's why you should call on us today. First Security, bank better.
Climax at ENWA, it's just an easy, customer-centered experience. Right now is probably the easiest time that I've ever seen to achieve financing for people on maybe even a more expensive vehicle or more accommodating vehicle for their family. I've got the best inventory, I would say, in the state, and my people are not only experienced in the car business, but they're experienced in the people business. Whether you just check us out online or you check us out in person, we want you to visit us. Claymax ENWA and ClaymaxENWA.com.
For over 20 years, Community Clinic has served Washington County with quality and affordable health care. With three wellness centers in Springdale, located at Jones, George, and Elmdale Elementary, our services include primary care, pediatrics, prenatal, behavioral health, and physical therapy. We offer services in English, Spanish, and Marseillaise so that we can help your family. The Community Clinic. Healthy people, healthy community.
At Northwest Health, you can check in online for urgent care and ER visits. This simple step lets you pick a time that's convenient and saves your spot in line before you arrive. It's our new approach to the waiting room. Visit mynorthwestanycare.com.
Here at HAR-BER, athletes make things run much smoother.
Need a runner. Two seconds slower than the last time, Chris. Come on.
Welcome back, sports fans. In the studio now is someone that needs no introduction, star hitter and San Diego State commit, Kat Cooper. Kat, last season you and the Lady Wildcats finished the season with a 12-5 record, 6-2 in the conference. Obviously, you had a ton of adversities, what I like to call the COVID season. So, I mean, how do you guys think that affected you last year?
COVID was really hard. I mean, including myself, we had a few girls who actually came down with the virus. So us coming back and having to do return to play process took us out from even more games that we had missed from being quarantined. So it was just hard missing games and not being in the rhythm of the season.
I mean, this team might be one of the best teams to ever come through HAR-BER volleyball history. With many, many D1 athletes on it, including yourself. What do you look to achieve this year on a personal level and as a team?
So as a team, obviously, I hope for a state tournament win and a conference championship this year. And that's something that all of us want as a group of seniors and as a team. And personally, I hope to be all state and all conference and just continue to build and support my team.
When it comes to this team, there's no shortage of experience. Obviously, there's only one junior and the rest are seniors. So you're definitely hungry for that state championship. I mean, how do you think that experience will help you in the long haul with state tournament?
A lot of experience means like you know the court, you know the game, and we all have a good mutual respect for each other and mutual goals that we all share. So I think us having the same mindset going into games and going into the season is really going to help us because we're all going to be on the same side.
We talked with Coach Lloyd earlier about one of the biggest rivalries probably for the HAR-BER volleyball team, which is HAR-BER versus Fayetteville. Mm-hmm. So is there something to prove this conference season? Do you want to prove anything?
There definitely is. I mean, we lost to them last year in the state tournament, obviously, and I think that that's a match that we could and should win this year. And I just hope to come out and prove what we can do.
Kat, thanks for joining us and good luck this year.
Thank you.
Now it's finally that time. This volleyball season is sure to be explosive with a stacked senior team full of D1 commits. And there's only one way to excite fans for this memorable season. Our team has been busy the last month crafting the 2021 HAR-BER volleyball hype video. Take a look.
Going outside. Great season for HAR-BER. Great season.
What is pain? What is pain to you? Do you understand? Do you even know what pain is? Stop running from it. Embrace the pain that you're gonna feel when you're trying to do something great. With greatness comes pain. Let's change what follows our I am. I am successful. I am powerful. I am great.
Wow.
I am amazing. Woo! You have to learn to embrace that pain. You have to learn to dig deep. When you feel that pain in your heart, when you're feeling pain, dig a little bit deeper. On the other side of pain is greatness. How bad do you want to be great?
How can you not be excited to watch that team dominate the 6A West? The Lady Wildcats start conference play September 2nd against Bentonville. Be sure to tune in, as WCSN will be there to provide all live event coverage. Let's take one last quick commercial break, but don't go anywhere. Coach Wood is standing by to talk McKinney, Texas. The Wildcat Sports Network will be right back.
During the Great Depression, nothing came easy. But with just 5 cents, an old truck, and a load of hay, John Tyson and his family found a way to deliver quality chicken to other hardworking people. Today, Tyson continues to find new ways to help put a chicken in every pot. Because people deserve farm-raised chicken of the highest quality. At Tyson, we remain committed to this simple promise. To always keep it real. To always keep it Tyson.
Try the 3-in-3 meal at Slim Chickens. 3 hand-breaded chicken tenders paired with 3 perfectly fried wings. Shaken in your choice of house flavors. Served with fries, Texas toast, and a medium drink. Slim Chickens. Fresh. Delicious. Chicken.
Thank you.
When accidents happen, our 30 minutes or less ER service pledge can mean less waiting and faster care. The 30 minutes or less ER service pledge at Northwest Health System Bentonville and Springdale.
Welcome home to Lindsay Living. From value-packed basic apartments with appliances and washers and dryers to resort-style apartment living on golf courses with fabulous amenities, you'll love where you live and play. Visit lindsaymanagement.com to apply online and see photos, rates, and floor plans for all locations we manage throughout Arkansas and in surrounding states.
At America's Car Mart, our purpose is providing customers peace of mind with quality vehicles to keep you on the road. And right now, we're kicking off 2021 with a huge sale, the New Year's sale. Drive away today for as low as $199 down on select vehicles. Ask about the New Year's sale or start your approval online right now. No matter where you are on your car buying journey, we're here for you, keeping you on the road. America's Car Mart.
Ozarks Go from Ozarks Electric Cooperative is leading the fiber revolution, connecting the divide with high-speed broadband access to close that gap. From cloud to cloud, post to post. From downtown to way out of town, to connect our customers to a world of blazing speed and access to absolutely everywhere. It's our customers connected and energized with Ozarks Go.
Choose the Wellness Centers at Springdale Schools. The Wellness Centers in Springdale are perfect for students and teachers. Teachers can go during their planning period, and parents don't have to miss work for students to receive medical care. Offering sports physicals, kindergarten physicals, vaccinations, well child checks, acute care, and more. Wellness Centers are located at a school near you. Wellness Centers and Springdale Schools, we are your medical home.
Hey Nick, catch.
Welcome back, Wildcats. Coach, tonight you got a huge game in one of the biggest and most expensive stadiums in the nation in McKinney, Texas. Is there any intimidation factor walking into that atmosphere like that? How do you maintain the focus?
Well, I mean, the biggest part is just the travel down. And, you know, it's about a five-hour ride. We're going to break the trip up a little bit, but we're going to go down the day of the game. You know, when it comes into the environment, I mean, our guys are used to playing in big venues and experiencing that stuff, so there will be no intimidation for us. I mean, you know, we look forward to the chance of playing there and giving our best effort to try to win that football game.
I mean, is there something to prove with tonight's game, or is it just an idea, purely a preseason matchup to work out the kinks?
Well, I mean, anytime you go into a game where you go across state lines, I mean, you're not only playing for your program, but you're playing for the state of Arkansas. And so that's something you want to do. You want to have those bragging rights, and you want to do a good job, and you want people to be proud of, you know, the product we're putting together in Arkansas. But, you know, the big scheme of things, our goal is to get our young guys experience, get them ready for conference play. I think this is a great matchup for us to do that because of their athleticism and their talent. It's going to be fun.
Mm-hmm. Just elaborating on that fun, what can we expect from tonight's game?
Well, I think you're going to think up-tempo from us offensively. We're going to try to get 70, 80 offensive snaps, really try to work the tempo there. Our kicking game, we spent a lot of time on that, so hopefully it'll be explosive for us as well. Defensively, those 11 guys that really run to the ball hard, we'll be a little bit undersized from a size standpoint, but that's okay. And so I just think you're going to get a group that's going to really compete hard and lay it on the field tonight. And, you know, McKinney, they do a really good job of what they're doing. They have a really good RPO system that they're throwing. Like I said, I think they've got 5, 6, or 7 guys that have D1 offers. And so I look forward to the matchup tonight.
What do the Wildcats need to do specifically to bring home the win tonight?
Well, you got to win turnover battle. You got to handle the momentum of the first quarter because McKinney's going to come out and try to set the tone. I told our guys all week, you got to be able to take that first punch and then counterpunch them. And so we just got to sustain, and keep ourselves calm through the first quarter, let everything settle down, then play football. But we've got to find a way to steal some points in the King game. And then third down, I think it's going to be really huge. Defense got to get off the field on third down. Offense got to keep drives alive, score points in the red zone.
Coach, thanks for joining us, and good luck tonight.
Thank you.
That's going to do it for the episode of the Wildcat Sports Network. On behalf of Superintendent Dr. Jared Cleveland, Athletic Director Wayne Stellick, I'm Connor Jenkins. Up next is kickoff. We'll see you next time. Touchdown, HAR-BER Wildcats, what a play!